take
your
on
clan
all
is a foul stench, but we are strong and yes, strong with stink.
You have just won your heart's desire, Eivor. Yet by the look on your face, you have lost your will to live.
Gorm is here with the last of his men. Why does that troll dare show his face?
Leave it for another day. We are here under Harald's truce, and Gorm is too weak to try anything bold.
Here's a seed stain on his father's trousers. I should wipe him from this world.
Not tonight, Eivor. Leave it.
Basim, watch over this one and see that he warms himself with drink. I will find my father and escort him to the longhouse.
As you wish.
Is Hytham well?
He will heal, but never fully recover. It is fortunate that you were able to succeed where he failed.
My resolve was strong.
When you slew Kjotve, did you see a sigil on him? Silver, the size of my palm, bearing the symbol of an ash tree?
Take it. Trade it for what you can.
I know where Gorm is camped. If you wish to see him without anyone the wiser, there is a trick I can teach you.
Already looking for another apprentice? All right, I'll bite. What do I do?
Use your cloak to obscure your face. Blend into the crowd. Divert attention. Hide in plain sight.
Is this how your brotherhood operates? You sneak around in the daylight, stepping your victims where they stand.
Said like that, you make me blush. We are seekers of justice, shepherds of man's will. We work in the dark to serve the light.
I suppose there's no shame in using deception when honor is at stake. And Gorm is a stain on that honor.
Then let's see what can be done to cleanse that stain. Give it a try. A few things you should know before you step into his camp. Walking unseen through hostile territory is an exercise in subtlety. A hood makes you forgettable, dismissed at a distance. Remain far from watchful eyes, and you will be invisible to them. Do not draw blade or hammer, for these and other sudden movements can break your disguise. And in case I wasn't clear, you would need to put up your hood for the trick to work. Gorm is there, in the camp ahead.
You have to eat something before drinking that much.
How does that go? Feed before me.
I want to talk to you.
I have some roasted lamb on a spit. Are you coming?
Eivor!
You Arga shit! Take up your weapon and follow me beyond these walls. Let Odin's favor land where it may.
You dare not break the king's peace here. So fuck you and your god talk. What say you to that? You can beat me, but you will not kill me. Not under Harald's truce.
You are all subject to King Harald's truce. Break his peace and you will be cast out of Alrikstad.
I will give you no trouble. You were shat into this world without honor, Gorm. And you will leave as a turd dumped into Hel's deepest ditch.
Keep crowing, Eivor. You only make yourself an easier target.
The Althing will have started. I should find Sigurd. To say. He does.
Thank you. His day will come. Oh, gods. I hate long speeches.
Only when you're not giving them.
Many of you knew my father, Halfdan the Black. A great man who achieved great things.
They buried Halfdan's leg near our temple. The crops have never grown tall.
They buried his arse near ours. And we get nothing but a muddy river!
I dream of something greater. A vast kingdom of warriors in numbers the world has never seen. United under one king, one rule. Too much blood has been spilled fighting one another. Today, we unify. And turn our blades outward to conquer new lands. And who better to lead us to glory than me? I was blooded before the age of 10, and I led the greatest army Norway has ever seen. But they say a wise king seeks honest counsel, so I ask, who among you rejects this new arrangement?
I am not your enemy, King Harald, but I will not be your subject. Tomorrow, we sail for greener shores, and so my kingdom is yours.
This saddens me, noble Hjor. And does your wife agree? Is she not tired of limping ever westward?
My husband and I are as one in this, Lord. We do not limp together. We fly.
I'm sad to lose a woman of your spirit, Ljúfvina. But I hold no grudge. May the fates grant you good luck.
My king! I offer you my axe and my oath, ironclad.
Gorm Kjötvason, you dare show your face in this hall. Did not King Styrbjörn and his son Sigurd rid our lands of your foulness?
The Raven Clan dishonored me, great king! They poisoned my father, Kjotve. They made a mockery of his honorable death.
Bakrat, you lie!
Hold, Eivor. Let it play out.
This is a serious charge, Gorm, and a false one at that. My uncle saw your father die. Eivor Wolfkist, you are Kjotve's slayer. This man has slandered your clan. What shall I do with him?
Exile, Lord. Banish him to the wilds where even a slave could kill him with impunity.
A wise choice. Death would be too easy a way out. Gorm, I name you Worm and call you exiled. Leave these lands by the next full moon, or I will feed you to the crows myself.
King Harald, may I speak?
The floor is yours, King Styrbjörn.
My people have held our land since the days when Odin himself walked among us. My kingdom is humble, but we have paid for it in blood. Our victory over Kjotve is proof that we will not lay down without a fight. All here have buried friends, brothers and sisters, sons and daughters. And I, for one, have had my fill of death. Let those who seek war look beyond our shores. If King Harald brings peace, then I am happy to bend my knee to him.
What? What in hell's name are you doing, father?
Securing a lasting peace, Sigurd. Our days of fighting are finished.
You said nothing of this to me. Not a word! And I will not yield a title that should be mine by right!
Then war will continue. Men will die, villages will burn, you foolish boy. This is our only way towards true peace.
You will die a thrall, you drink-addled cow! Alone and toothless in a bed of straw!
Forgive my son. He is ruled by his emotions.
I take no offense, Styrbjörn Jarl, and I thank you for your fealty. It is natural to fear change, to resist it. But all things change and all things end. The lessons of Ragnarök are clear. We will speak again soon.
That was an ambush, Lord. Did you know of Styrbjörn's plans?
For some days, yes, I did. But it was not at my urging. It was his decision alone. Do you dream of a glorious future, Eivor? A warrior like you would be a boon to my clan.
I dream of a glorious death, but not at the cost of betraying my family.
You intrigue me, Wolfkist. Orphan and sibling, warrior and poet. You are many in one, it seems.
You know much about me.
I have eyes and ears everywhere, as any effective king must. Would you not be one of my ravens?
I'm bound to Sigurd, and he to me. But if fate should cross our threats again...
I understand. Yet should your fortunes change, you are welcome in my hall. But let us leave these matters for another time. Tonight, we will eat and drink like gods and wake in a kingdom made new.